So I spent most of the day looking after my geriatric rat, Shmi. I took her to the vet for an emergency visit because I thought her bladder was distended or something, but really she just put on weight. And while I was up there, I took this photo. And then I spent the rest of the day editing this friendship video for my friend Timothy. We had to catch the train. And then we went for drinks at Mika, which is a beer bar in Bushwick. We surprised our friend Timothy. This is what the bar looked like. And they were playing Les Triplettes de Belleville inside. For dinner, we did outdoor dining at Otis in Bushwick. I don't really know how to describe Otis. It has a small but eclectic menu that stays the same year round, and they're also pretty famous for their cocktails too. I had mussels in this like peppery, lemony, creamy broth with house-made bread. And I had a ton to drink because it was our friend's last night in New York, so.
Okay, I'm gonna say just one thing per person because I don't know how to like, not one thing per person, but like one thing, like not, I'm gonna say things to people individually, not to the whole group, because I can't just speak to the whole group. Kristen and Annie, literally the best roommates ever. I love you guys, I love living with you.
I'm Tommy Shannon.
Dylan, Melvin, and Maurice.
Monopoly boys.
I love to play Monopoly with all you guys.
Three times a day.
Yeah. That's really pretty.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Jasmine or whatever.
Oh, that's so silly.
Jasmine, late night talks.
Stop looking at
me. Zanna, literally the sweetest. I love you.
I feel that.
It was drinks, Josh. I literally heard you changing
my career. You go, Tran. You go. Anyways, I love you guys.
Then we walked back to Annie's apartment.
Oh, wait, I want to get in this.
And then we surprised him.
Welcome home!
Happy birthday, Timothy. Surprise!
Birthday!
I did all of this.
Actually, it was his birthday a week later, but this was really just like a going away surprise. Here we're singing happy birthday, but only the birthday part, because we saw it on TikTok. And we've just been doing it ever since. At this point, me and Josh were pretty much just eating every balloon. And then we showed him the friendship video, and then we headed to the roof. This bitch is always flicking me off. Anyways, he kept expecting a surprise on the roof. Obviously, there wasn't one.
I love it.
I think we just gave him too many surprises. Also, this is his roof. Like, he knows what it looks like. And then we send him off.
they're like going somewhere and like I don't realize that this is the last time we'll see them.
Well, I mean, just for a while until next. Love you!
Love you.
And then I walked to White Castle by myself. Yeah, so sorry about all the like weird and mismatched footage. When I started making this video, I didn't know it was gonna be like a week of my life type vlog. I didn't even know what I was making. So I kind of just like used whatever I had. Still, I'm not like really still sure what I'm doing. But as the video goes on, it gets better, or at least it doesn't get worse. Okay, so I actually forgot to record anything on this day, but here's my camera roll from that day. So I just kind of put these 3 days together because there wasn't enough content to make for 3 individually interesting days. I mostly just drank soup for pretty much every meal. I watched a lot of Great British Baking Show. I finished drawing and signing these birthday cards for my friends. And I finally got to do laundry, which is one of my favorite things to do. I couldn't do it before because I thought I had COVID, so I was just waiting for my test results to come back negative, and they finally did. Anyways, it was super cathartic. I just got this shirt from Depop. Whenever I'm waiting for the washer or dryer, I usually just run some errands, like go to the dollar store or the hardware store, or just look at like any stores nearby. I took the scenic walk back. Whenever I see an animal in the street, I always try to interact with it. There's a cat in pretty much every bodega or every store in Brooklyn. This was from another day. This was also from another day. Then I walked to the grocery store. They had Halloween decorations up. Then I walked home. And honestly, I probably watched Great British Baking Show that night. Cooked a bunch of vegetables. Look up if it's safe though before feeding it to your rat. And then I biked to my friend's house because we're gonna watch a scary movie, which I never do because I hate scary movies. I got BK Taco Factory in Bushwick. We watched Wrinkles the Clown because I actually like true crime and I don't mind clowns.
And him come here and you know, you hear all those bad stories and it was scary at first.
Remember when I had to take out my box spring? Because I got real creeped out when I...
I love you guys.
Bye.
Me, time for your medicine. It rained all day, which I love. I did some freelance work. I did some general getting my life together type things. I drank some soup. I watched my stocks go to shit, and then I made an apple pie. I had all these apples I had to use from apple picking in upstate New York. And I carved the frog from over the garden wall in the pie because we were gonna watch that later that night. Here's me with the pie. Ignore how manic I looked. I walked over in the rain. And then for dinner, we had all these different soups from Soup Queen, which is a friend of my friend who sells soups on Instagram. And also this focaccia from Sergina in Bed-Stuy that was so fresh and oily. Also, Paul made these like apple cider, whiskey, lemon, sort of, I don't know what kind of drink. And I didn't really record anything because at this point I was still shy about vlogging, so here's one of my favorite scenes from Over the Garden Wall.
Over the treetops and mountains, over the blackened ravines, then softly it falls by a house near a stream, and over the garden wall to thee.
I knew you were special.
So I also forgot to record on Saturday, so here's my camera roll from that day. Okay, so I'm including Sunday because this was actually a pretty eventful day. I was going to Central Park with Paul that morning. I did my hair and makeup, which I only do like once a week. I like to remind myself that I can look cute if I try. Or actually, like, cute's not the word. I wanted to feel put together. I forgot to record my coffee that day, but it was a spiced latte with oat milk from Birch. Here's Paul's iced coffee. I personally drink a lot of hot coffee pretty much all year round, unless it's like really sweltering. We saw some people painting in the park. We tried to lure some squirrels.
Okay, do the thing again.
I was making that sound and Paul was doing that, like, this hand wave thing. We talked to this nice man playing the violin who told us about this hidden garden overlooking a tiny waterfall by the pond.
Thank you.
And of course, I didn't record it. Instead, I recorded this rat. People watched.
I want to be in that picture. I want to be in that picture.
Also watched some geese. Here's Paul's photo of a goose. And here's photos of me. We made our way to Sheep's Meadow and put down a blanket. Paul looked at some dogs while I looked at some fall foliage, which was the whole reason why we went to the park in the first place, but we came a bit early in the year, so it's mostly green still. We witnessed a séance. And then I looked at some birds while Paul ate a Nathan's hot dog. At this point, I was pretty much set on getting Chipotle, so I ditched Paul at West 4th Street and went on to get a burrito bowl. At this point, one of my best friends, Annie, called to invite me to get a tattoo with her for her birthday, and it ended up being kind of like a tattooing birthday party, social gathering of under 10 people. After seeing the flashcard once, I pretty much knew I wanted this little bat from one of the artist's flashcards. Bats are rat adjacent, and this one has a little rat butt.
Bye, Annie.
Bye. I'm gonna be a different woman the next time you guys see me.
I know I'm already recording, but can I record this? I'm trying to stitch things together and see if I can make a vlog. But I don't know if I want to put it anywhere. Annie, you look like a baby drinking from a little sippy cup. What are you drinking?
Oh. Since I started, look how bold they are. Like, you know, like,
yeah.
It's so crazy. This one was single needle, but this one is
good. Oh, cool.
This one too. This one is teaching a friend. This
really?
One, yeah.
Oh.
This one, a friend testing a machine.
I love all the tattoos that have like strings behind them. I love that.
So,
I like your whole leg.
Was that the girl that gave me Palmer's? Oh, this is so good.
I love.
You're fresh now.
Oh, you wanted another tattoo?
Yeah.
So a bunch of people just tattooed randomly.
Yeah. Jasmine, I just feel like this is very you. Like, it just represents who you are as a person, you know?
Oh, he loves it.
I do way better on tattoos than I do the next one.
On and then a full one kind of just above it.
Like it's like kind of stuck.
And obviously the butterflies would be little.
Here's me getting tattooed. Here's the finished tattoo. I also got this little sparkle on my finger, but it's already faded, so I need to get redone. Also, I was pretty hellbent on tattooing myself, so with the artist's supervision, I did this to myself.
Mace is just knocked out with a jewel in her hand.
Yes.
Cheers. Why Mace? Why let Mace do your tattoo?
There's tangerine lemon.
I need someone who tapped me. Oh.